Hi, my name is Sergeant First Class James Johnson. I'm assigned to the Soldier Support Institute, Fort Jackson, South Carolina. Recently, I graduated from the Advanced Business Analytic course at the Dollar Moore School of Business, University of South Carolina. The final group project, presented by Captain Johnson of Fort Carson, Specialist Natial of the 24th FMSU, and myself, formed the foundation of the Financial Management Common Operating Picture, or FMCOP, that I will demonstrate today. The purpose of the FMCOP is to serve as a bridge between the commander's lines of effort and the money he or she spends to achieve their desired end state. Ultimately, the FMCOP will be integrated into the Sustainment Readiness Tool. The basic layout of the FMCOP will be standardized for all budget offices, from brigade-level echelons through Corps. However, the FMCOP is fully customizable to support the commander's request on demand. The FMCOP originates as an export file from GFIBS. The size of the exported data is often very large. The size of the sample used to create this COP was over 300,000 rows long. The units depicted in this FMCOP were selected for presentational purposes only and do not in any way reflect actual financial data for the current fiscal year. The benefit of utilizing the FMCOP is that financial managers now can analyze large amounts of data and transform it into useful visual information commanders can use to get a clear understanding of their financial picture. The FMCOP is displayed as a digital dashboard using complex pivot tables and pivot charts to refine GFIPS data into vital operational information easily interpreted by commanders and other staff elements. Using this tool to operationalize the commander's financial picture provides leaders with an interactive digital environment using command buttons and chart slicers to change chart types, as well as filter by fiscal quarters, units, and commitment items. Now, let me demonstrate the functionality of the FMCOP. The first dashboard shows commander spending as it relates to lines of effort. Here, data can be filtered by LOE and campaign objectives using the embedded slicers to the left of the visual. As each LOE is selected, the corresponding CO will be available for selection. To select multiple LOEs or COs, repress and hold the control key and make the selections. To clear filters, the commander selects the red X that appears on the top of the slicer. The buttons on the bottom of the visual will switch the view from a stack column chart to a bar chart. The dashboard also allows the commander to view LOE spending by quarter. A drop-down filter at the top of the data table allows the commander to see obligations by unit. This feature displays one or multiple units at a time. The next dashboard shows the commander their financial picture of total obligations by fiscal quarter using a pivot table and data bar formatting. The data bars provide a visual representation of the data inside each cell. This feature will allow commanders to quickly find large amounts of spending as opposed to continuously searching numbers to find the same information. As with the previous dashboard, slices are added to allow for filtering through units. To demonstrate, suppose the commander wants to see the top two units with the most obligations, the one on first cab and the first ABCT. So we select the two brigades. Now, suppose she wants to look further at the top two battalions, the GSAB and the 3rd BSB. In a matter of seconds, the commander now sees only what is needed to be analyzed further with just a few clicks. As more data is needed to further analysis, a dashboard is available to depict spending by commitment items. The Spending by Commitment Items dashboard utilizes a pivot chart and command buttons to change the chart view, just as in the first dashboard. The data represented on this dashboard are the top 10 obligations by commitment items. The slicers on the right allow the data to be filtered by battalions. To demonstrate, suppose the commander wants to look further into the obligations made by the GSAB. If she wanted to see the data in another view, we simply press the command buttons at the bottom to change the pivot chart view. The commander now is able to have a better understanding of which commitment items are driving obligations for the GSAB within seconds. Our last dashboard also shows the top 10 obligations by commitment items, but presented on a pivot table and by fiscal quarter. Data is highlighted using a blue heat map. The color intensity increases as the amount of obligations increase. This feature allows for the commander to further analyze which commitment items are the biggest drivers of spending. The yellow highlighted cells on the bottom of the pivot table show the commitment items that have the least amount of obligations. A drop-down option at the top of the pivot table allows data to be viewed by fiscal quarter. Here, the commander can choose to view all quarters in the data sample, only a selected few, or just one. An added bonus to this pivot table is the ability to further analyze a cell by double-clicking inside it. This will generate a separate worksheet with all the raw data that was used to calculate the total as shown. The worksheet comes with data filters, so data can be analyzed more efficiently. In summary, the FMCOP provides commanders and other staff elements at brigade level echelons and above an interactive digital visualization of their financial picture using complex pivot tables, pivot charts, slicers, macros, and command buttons. It also serves as a tool for the financial manager to quickly convert large amounts of raw data exported from GFIBS to useful data that can be customized and shown in a variety of ways in a matter of minutes.